Yes. So, professional ethics are extremely important in audit, right? Because we have different stakeholders that rely on the information that we provide. Now, before we even talk about professional ethics in the context of audit, why do you think ethics is important? Always make the right choice, right? If you're faced with a situation where you think there's something wrong, something, you know, that tells you that it's not right, obviously, you know, more than likely you have an ethical issue or an ethical dilemma. So if you think about a standard, a pre-standard ethical issue, let's say one of your friends, you guys are taking an exam, one of your friends wants to cheat, or is actually cheating, right? Do you think that's an ethical issue?
Yes.
Why do you think that's an ethical issue? Into the code of professional ethics. refers to the conduct or the qualities that characterize a profession or a professional person. For the classification of ethical orientations, we have four different approaches that we can take. There's the absolutist, situationist, we also have exceptionist, and subjectivist. And these are just to show you that there's different approaches to dealing with an ethical situation. And also these concepts are based on relativism and also idealism. So what is an ethical problem? A problem situation exists when a person has to make a choice among many different choices, and the right choice or the right decision is not absolutely clear. An ethical problem situation can be described as one in which the choice can actually impact the well-being of different people. So if we think about, you know, going back to the example of your friend cheating during the exam, some of you may think that, you know, it's none of your business, it's not a big deal. But somebody else may think, you know, it's not fair. A lot of us study very hard for this exam. So you will go and tell the professor. But again, there's just different approaches on how you would deal with a situation. And you have to do what you think is the best thing.
Big deal is just not lying. For me, it's a value. Yeah, I don't like being lied to, and I don't like lying.
Of course. Totally. Yes. In the philosophical sense and the code of professional ethics.
Sarah, UI controller, subsidiary of a small private company. And you, trying to decide if you should use one more word.
It's like 0.5%. 0.5%.
Because you think that if you use realistic projections, you risk the chance of not receiving the fund and project is not taking it.
It depends on my boss.
And the company will suffer and 100 plus and a
billion slacks
lose their jobs.
Yeah, there's a lot of people. On top of that, you're going to have 5%.
So we think that every employee, the component of the situations.
Right.
So we first look at the natural consequences. Well, if we don't use optimistic projection, people will lose a job and then you'll go under. But on the other hand, if you use optimistic projections and get the fund, but the project didn't do well, company would still go and people still lose a job. And for in the worst case scenario, you get caught in jail.
Right.
And then we look at the probability of the effect, and then we think that it's better to choose realistic projection. Yeah, and possibly look for other ways to help the company.
So you thought about it in terms of the propensity, right?
Yeah.
And you decided that the best decision is to project the realistic figures.
So if you get the funds, then other people are sure you got the funds because you can deliver.
Okay.
So specifically, not being sure doesn't mean everybody else is not sure.
Right.
The
so
other
that's
thing
a different way to think about it.
Yeah,
right?
The other thing we considered is that in the realistic way, you're gonna lose jobs for 100 people. So who's gonna put bread on the table?
Again, right?
Yeah. So
100 people are realistic jobs.
Yeah. So even if you don't deliver on the first. On the optimistic, you can only, as a manager, you can only lose the job, but the 100 people, not everybody else loses the job.
Okay.
That's how we look at it.
Okay, so we have three responses. Anybody else? Yes?
So, you said that the controller in general should try to revisit the projections and kind of try to find something in between, to find a rare, maybe, because the projection is not something set in stone, it's a prediction of what's going on in the company. So it's it's a hard situation because if you go realistically, then your plan might close and then you're responsible for the jobs of 100 other employees. But then again, you want to be conservative, you don't want to be too optimistic. So maybe if they can find something that's not necessarily optimistic, but something that's a little aggressive, maybe something where we say that, okay, workers will need to work overtime to get projections to meet goals much quicker and more efficiently, but also something that's kind of conservative at the
Yeah.
Okay.
So, due to the fact that you gotta trust the class information, it's kind of going into a process of like kind of availability where you kind of like see the information that they're putting out and kind of just agreeing with them.
Okay.
Which is not right for us to auditing it.
Says that
say, like, the problem here right off the bat, it says your firm has audited the XML people several decades.
Right.
It might be like an issue of familiarity.
Sorry.
Right.
So you inherently think the climate's honest.
Right, yeah.
Right.
But that aggressive revenue recognition policy that we have, it might lead to a problem like down the road. So if they keep on doing, it's been there for several decades, but if they keep on doing it, their company might go under eventually just because of, overestimate or optimist, like overestimated projections or accepting revenue too aggressively, too much.
Okay.
And then later on that might hurt your firm too.
Okay. All good points. Does anybody have a different answer? Or they think this should keep the client? It's a big client, right?
My only kind of consent to be visit the revenue recognitions.
Okay.
Procedures.
So in case that go ahead.
You might want to find out what other companies within the same industry that they're doing. Is it logical to then recognize?
Okay. So you would kind of fill in expectations. So what everybody else is doing, maybe
yeah.
This is something that happens a lot in the industry.
Yeah, because
okay.
You want to find that your client is actually overstating the profit.
Okay, right. You were going to say something?
I was going to say that. Them to like maybe slow down a little bit and go over their policies and just make sure they do conform with GAAP. And if they do, listen, I guess that's fine.
Okay.
And just go over their statements as well. Because if they're not doing anything wrong in their accordance to GAAP, it's fine. But yeah, I would advise them to like slow down, not be as aggressive as they are. Look at the industry as well, see what they're doing. Like, that was the building.
So in most cases we're not going to retain the client, but in other cases we will talk to the client, make sure they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. Auditors were supposed to serve the public interest, right? So if the client has a very aggressive revenue recognition policy, you guys are right, you would talk to the client, make sure they're not hiding anything, they're reporting what they're supposed to be. Or you could also decide to not keep the client because it's just too risky. And I'm sure you guys have covered the audit risk model, right? So you have to accept it a certain level of risk. It has to be low enough for you to accept the audit and continue with the client. Who wants to discuss case 4?
Similar to this optimistic projections thing, it's just different.
Yes.
We included the slack based on the fact that 5% is you can slack with a 95% confidence that the budget will work with a 5%. Yeah, like
well,
you have.
I think they're making a case that
So 95% is material. The percentage. So you are basing it on a percentage, like you have the confidence of 95% confidence if you are doing the statistic.
Right. So you're saying because the 95% is material, 5%
yeah.
is
it's immaterial,
material,
so
you
can,
the budget.
Yeah, you can allow that error, marginal error.
Yes.
If somebody should be able to come in and do like follow exactly what your procedure is that. Does it have to be to divide that number? If not, like you get a number and then whatever number you get, you put like 5% more on it or 5% less on it. Kind of like you manipulating.
Right, but if it's not material, everybody else is doing it.
Should you have to be able to explain.
Right. So your gut tells you this is, everybody's doing it, but it's probably not the right thing to do.
Wouldn't be the correct response. Somebody say, hey, why did you do it because everybody else is doing it?
Right. Sorry?
That'd be like
group thing. Right. That's not that one your minds. Did you have your hand up? Okay. Right. So, you know, just because everybody's doing it, it doesn't mean that it's okay to do. Especially if you're an accountant, right? You have to report the numbers. Report the accurate numbers, make sure the numbers are communicated and stated in a fair way.